April 6th, it's 2:40 p.m. Had a good rain yesterday, saturated with the, whatever you want to call it, chemtrail-laced rain, whatever. Just coming out here looking at this, oh, it's coming, the flooding areas. So, you know, before we put, when we put the plastic down, the flooded area was around in here. I moved the dirt, you can see it's more of a hill right here, but then look right there now. So I'm gonna try putting rows that are like right around the edges of that. Just to the edge and get a little bit of that water there and over there. Just right where that'll be a main one, we'll leave it alone. Plant. And here's another bed. Spotty puddles. See. Walking in mud out here, crap. Well, we get sawdust. We should get some of that sawdust since we're out here. Just a little walkway. And I tied strings out here last night, yesterday, before anything happened. This is one quarter of the piece of the fencing that they have, and I put two strings on there for that. Put beams on this, and this is like a row here. I don't know, I might put some black eyed pea bushes down here to come up. And then over here, I'm not gonna worry, it's too muddy. But we got 2, 4, 6, 8 over here with those partial fences, you know, there's like four of them together, eight of them together actually. Two, four, six, eight. These four here would be one, those four there would be one, that goes back there, and these two right here. But see how I got the strings tied out for them. And then those are the okra. We got spineless okra in the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we got red okra, the middle 16. And then the last row closest to the strings is spineless okra that I put down yesterday with a little bit of 15-15-15 fertilizer. And then that potting soil right there has got some lime mixed in with it too, so gives some potassium. So, yeah, see, when the hole's cut in these two, this the water will go into the ground. So it won't be that bad if it was like that puddle right there. That's 2 feet for it to go there, just that one area. It's going to dissipate and spread out as I walk through the mud. Ew, mud. Poo-poo. And that's mud. Yeah, that's too deep right there. Wait and see my flowers start coming up. That's going to be a big ding if they ever do start coming up. Marigold across the front here. Sunflowers on the back here. And I got to get some big sunflowers. I'm going to do the back, the northern end of that all the way across. I'm going to put the sunflowers like I have on that end down there. I'm going to plant sunflowers. I don't know if I'll do that while it's muddy or wait. I might do that later on today. Well, it's still kind of moist out here. Just put the seed in there, let the ground, because the ground's right at 50 degrees or warmer now, so all the flowers and all that should come up within the next couple of weeks, start popping up. But like I say, still got grass and all that I gotta get out. I gotta be careful because I'm gonna be pulling off the flowers as I'm pulling off the grass. Should be able to tell the difference though. All right, well, that's the garden.